Hello, and I'd like to welcome you all once again to the old schoolhouse here in the village of Butterstone in Perthshire for this, our seventh live broadcast in nearly as many days. And to explain a wee bit, the village of Butterstone has 10 houses, and this was the old village school. For those of you who haven't tuned in before, this was the old village school, and it's the village school that I went to, and my father went to it in the 1930s. And luckily, for the last 30 years, once it was closed down, I've had it as my recording studio, and this is where I've made all my recordings. So it's lovely to be able to make these broadcasts from an old building which has got so much connection to my family. It's been a very, very windy day outside, actually, a stormy, windy day. In fact, I spent most of my day trying to kind of hold down my little plastic polytunnel from blowing away where all my seats were. So it's been a very stressful day. And I'm going to do a couple of songs that I haven't done for a long time. So, we'll just see how we get on with them, and hope that I can remember the words. And a number of years ago, I have got a wee house up on the west coast of the island of Lewis. And my family are all native Gaelic speakers from the west coast of Mull. And it was great for me. I'd grown up with a lot of Gaelic in the house and lots of wee bits and pieces of things, but I didn't really understand a lot of it. But the community where I had the house up in Lewis was a Gaelic-speaking community, and most of the old folk were speaking Gaelic in everyday life and in the shops and stuff and that. And so it was really important for me and profound to gonna be able to spend some time making connection with what was my past, you know, that kind of Gaelic culture. And particularly things like, I was out on fishing with this old man, and I remember he says, "Oh, yeah, there's a nice reef over here," he says. "As soon as we're over that reef," he says, and I was leaning over the front of the boat, and he says, "You should just about see it just about now." And sure enough, as he said that, the reef appeared below the boat. And I said to him, "How did you do that?" And he says, "Well, I lined up these three islands there. And if you see that crack on that other island, there's a wee burn. When they're all lined up, that means I'm exactly over the top of the reef." And I love that kind of knowledge. So we'll try the song and see. I have been strengthened, mere distant sun. Fill my sails with winds to lead me on, and on the swell of the great Atlantic Sea, I find forgotten roots to stay. Winds of change widely comes to me, unfolding endlessly. I have been opened, me the restless one. You give me paths of rock to walk upon, and in the shelter of the trainish sand, you give me gentle shore on which to land. Thank you. island signs meet with others from the shore. We sail through channels deep like those who've gone before. And in the helter, the Hebridean night, we turn her head round, sailing out of sight. And now I can be free within these winds of change. Thank you very much. That was my song, Distant Sun. And I'm going to continue with a... I'm just going to change guitars here. I used a couple of different guitar tunings, and it's nice to have them already tuned. This wee song came from... I've been asking for people to kind of call in and let me know where they're watching from. And I got this little message from somebody in New Zealand in a place called Waipu. And it's fascinating because I have a song, and I'm going to sing it now. And it involves this wee village of Waipu, which is up in the North Island of New Zealand. And I remember I was doing a tour there, and I had to stop. I was coming down the island, and I had to stop off to go to the toilet. And I pulled into this little town called Waipu, and I sort of parked in the entrance to this old graveyard. And I walked in, and I noticed that all around all the graves in the graveyard were all McDonald's or McGregor's or, you know, all from Ascent. Well, you know, late of St. Anne's Bay, Cape Breton, but all from... originally from Ascent. And it was very curious, and there was a wee museum in the town, and I went in, and there was a couple of lovely old ladies, and they explained to me this amazing story about the Reverend Norman MacLeod, who was a minister in the west coast of Scotland up in Ascent. And he had decided to take all his 800 parishioners, because times were very hard up on the west coast of Scotland, and he decided to take them all to Canada. And so they all packed up and went to Canada, and when they arrived there, it was just this wild bush, and they cleared the bush, and they made little cottages, and they made a big church. But it's so cold in Cape Breton, and then in the wintertime, the sea's all iced over. So they stayed there for about 20 years, I think, and then for some reason, the Reverend decided that they would all pack up and go to Australia. And because they'd come from Scotland, they were all boat builders, and so they cut down the trees, built their own boats. It took them 6 months to sail. The whole community went, and it took them about 6 months to get to Waipu in New Zealand. They ended up, in fact, in Waipu. And they just abandoned the houses and abandoned the community. And I was very lucky. Some years later, I went to Cape Breton, and I went down to St. Anne's Bay where they built the ships. And I realised now that I'd been at all three. I'd been at Ascent, where they'd left from. I'd been in St. Anne's Bay, where they had built the ships. And I'd been in Waipu in New Zealand, where they had settled and had this lovely little community. So I realised that it was the young men who had left Ascent were actually the old men who arrived in New Zealand. It had taken them a whole lifetime to find a place for them to set up their safe little community. So I wrote this song. It's called Boatbuilders, and go and explore that. It's the Reverend Norman MacLeod. He was a bit of a holy terror, I think, a bit of a wild terror. We'll try and see how we got on, anyway. I was there on the cold acid hills. I heard the hunger cry and the tyrants laughing. I heard the young men say goodbye to the place where their young dreams had grown. But there's a land. Thank you very much. And that's my song, Boatbuilders. And if you get a chance to read a little bit about that amazing journey, somebody should make a movie about it. There was only, I think there was about six children born on the, I think they built eight boats, and there were six children born on the crossing, and nobody died, and they all got there in one piece. It's brilliant. So that was from the gentleman from Waipu who put the message on my Facebook page. This is the point where we do a wee bit of a sing-along thing here, and I thought this was quite a wee relevant song to sing. I haven't done this for years either, for a while anyway. And it seems to me as you go through life, you're allowed to make mistakes, you know. You're allowed to make mistakes and fall down. The one thing you mustn't do is going to give up and just going to lie down and do nothing, you know. Because as long as you're making lots of mistakes, it means that you're tackling the whole business of life kind of head on. Particularly in these very troubled times, you know, I think this wee song is going to be a nice chorus. And you sing, you can fall, but you must not lie down. You can fall, but you must not lie down. I know you're lost in the deep of the fiddle's sweet sound. You can fall, but you must not lie down. And so we'll see how you get on with this at home. And tuning problem here, just bear with me. So this is a wee place where when I'm not in isolation, a fiddle player would be playing a wee riff here. But there's just me and Mr. Potato Head stage tonight, so I'm going to get you to sing the wee fiddle riff as well as the chorus. Mr. Potato Head said, in case if you don't realise, this is Mr. Potato Head, who's in my company on the stage here. And, because we have a kind of automatic camera system, I needed somebody to be able to focus the cameras for, and because it's just me and Jen here in the old schoolhouse. We have been for a couple of weeks now, and it's just me and Jen, so I have to focus the cameras myself and set them all up. So Mr. Potato Head stands here and does that for me, and then he plays fantastic guitar during the show. So he said he would help sing the fiddle bit.
Fall, but you must not lie.
fall, you must not lie down. That's the chorus. We'll try it again. Here we go. You can fall, but you must not lie down. You can fall, but you must not lie down. I know you're lost in the deep of the fiddle's sweet sound. Oh, you can fall, but you must not lie down. Pull in your tired wings. Oh, there's no need to know it all. Listen how the silence sings. Now's the time for standing tall. And when you're standing on your highest hill, and you shout but no one, you can fall, but you must not lie down. You can fall, but you must not lie down. I know you're lost in the deep of the fiddle's sweet sound. Oh, you can fall, but you must not. I know you're lost in the deep of
and fall, but you must not lie down. Da 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 da.
Thank you very much, and that was my tune, Not Lie Down, and I hope you enjoyed that. It's a bit more of a difficult chorus for you to sing tonight, but nice to stretch yourself. I'm going to finish with this wee song, and we're all getting ready to go outside at 8 o'clock to have the big applause for our National Health Service workers and our carers and all the people. So we're going out there at 8 o'clock. So I'm going to finish up just now so that you can all get out there and get on the street and give a real big make a lot of noise for these wonderful people who are out there at the sharp end of this whole carry on. And thank you very much for all the people that are out there keeping the wheels of our lives rolling while we are all kind of stuck in our houses here. I really appreciate it, and I think you're all brilliant. So I've got the front of the school all floodlit blue with the NHS colours, and me and Jan are going out. So I'm going to do this song now. People keep writing, people asking for this song and asking for this song and asking for this song. And I did it on the second show, but there seemed to be something screwed up about the on the demand one on Facebook. You can see it on YouTube and Vimeo, I think, but on Facebook it's something screwed up. So I'm going to do it again, and do this so that something here. Now I've got to, before I finish, I'm just going to read you out some of the, we've been getting such amazing response, and people from all over the world writing in thanking me for doing this, and for me and Jen, and we're enjoying it. And I keep asking people to tell me where they're calling from, where they're watching from, and we've had some amazing places over the last two or three nights. And I've got another big list tonight, and it's mind-boggling, actually. I'm just going to read it out to you where we have people watching from. There's people watching from Kuwait, from Moscow, from Slovakia. There's folk from South Wales, Uruguay, the Faroe Islands, Santander in Spain, Guernsey in the Channel Islands. I've actually been there. It's an amazing place. Bahrain, and Saronno in Italy. I did a couple of concerts many, many years ago in Saronno. And some people watching from Portugal. And in Australia, there are people from Campbell River in Western Australia. There's people in Hobart in Tasmania, and Yorkeys Island in the far north of Queensland. Yorkeys Knob in the far north of Queensland. Well, I don't know if that's what it says, but it doesn't sound right to me, but I bet it's a beautiful place. So I'm going to finish this with I don't know if you can see the changes that have come over me in these last few days. I've been afraid that I might drift away, so I've been telling old stories, singing songs that make me think about where I came from. That's the reasons why I seem so far away. If I should become a stranger, you know traveling dreams, yes, there's no denying I traveled hard, with conscience flying somewhere with the wind. Oh, but let me tell you that I love you, that I think about you all the time. Caledonia, you're calling me, now I'm I should become a stranger. You know that it would make me more than sad. Caledonia's been everything I've ever sitting here before the fire, the empty room, the forest choir, the flames that couldn't get any higher. Well, then whether now they've gone, but I'm steady thinking, my way's clear, and I know what I will do tomorrow when the hands are shaken and the kisses. Thank you very much, and that's my wee homesick song, Caledonia. And I'm going to finish and leave you with that now, and thank you for being a fantastic wee audience, and thanks for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed singing along, and we're doing these wee shows. I'm trying to make this feel like a little bit of a concert so that you you get the beer out, you get a wee can of beer out and a wee bit of a popcorn or whatever it is, and get the big telly out up and sit there and pretend you're at a, just forget about what's going on and pretend you're at a wee gig. And so thanks for joining me, and I'll see you in a couple of nights' time. So on behalf of Mr. Potato Head and myself, you all take care of yourselves, look after each other, and I'll see you in a couple of nights. Aikavaa.